Wassalatu wassalam upon all the messengers of Allah who do not make any difference or distinction between them all. And that is from Adam alayhi salam to our Prophet Muhammad. May Allah have mercy on all of them and forgive their sins. Ameen. Under 9 minutes is a new series where I will deliver from time to time, of course, some snippets about certain things. Sometimes it's an ayah from the Qur'an, sometimes maybe it's just a historical fact, but they all evolve around opening your eyes towards what Allah truly wants from you. You see, people today are busy. Even though they all claim that Islam is important to them, just like getting rich is important to them, but nobody does what they need to do to feed their souls from this beautiful religion. I spend days, and Allah knows sometimes weeks, in continuous research. Sometimes one idea that I deliver to you in 2 minutes takes me about 3 weeks to actually formulate. Look around, search in history, look in the Quran, search the different views of the scholars, of the school of thoughts, and all what have you got, so that I deliver to you on a golden platter that you take and apply. Yet, people get back to me with questions, asking me questions in the group, either in the group or at personal or through YouTube or whatever it is. And they ask me questions about topics that I have already covered, points that I have truly explained. And it really makes me feel like, really? Really? You didn't take 1 hour out of a whole week to listen to a talk that's going to illuminate you, bring you closer to Allah, make Islam a lot easier as Allah intended it. And you don't do all that, and then you get back to me asking me a question about a topic that I've already covered. Well, you can see the bummer here. So I usually don't answer these people, and I tell them I've already covered this topic, and if I am good enough, I will just send them a link to the YouTube channel. Sometimes I'm in a dilemma. People are extremely touchy, and if you tell them I don't do this, then guess what? They start formulating an opinion, and then they probably will just altogether stop asking or stop wanting to know. And then I came to this revelation, or so to speak, this awakening. Hey, if people are not responsible enough, why should I care about them? You see, I'm not a messenger from Allah sent to you. I'm just somebody who discovers things and enjoys Islam. And I've taken it upon myself for the last 35 or so years to share that knowledge that I have acquired through years, the experience, and deliver to people. You're free to take or reject what I say. But at the end of the day, all I'm doing is opening your eyes towards the ultimate truth, and that is the Quran, and so that you get out of the bondage. You see, the Jews have this historical bondage that they are doomed and all that kind of stuff, and rightly so, because Allah has written upon them the wrath, punishment, and all what you know about in the Quran. But we live in an unneeded, ungiven to by Allah to us bondage. Allah never made us to feel miserable. Allah never ever commanded in the Quran that a man would go out on a hot day in shorts with wearing half sleeves or short sleeves and wearing just a t-shirt on his body with his shorts, and they usually wear them by the knees or a little bit below the knees or a little bit above the knees. But a woman would go out there completely covered in a garment that shows nothing of her body, a thick garment and black. Did Allah make this Islam? No, of course not. So how did women end up dressed up like that? The 3rd century scholars, hadith. My job is to point you to the Quran. This is why I have decided to go along and do this under 9 minutes series, where I, as I said, each time pick up an article, a subject, a topic, an ayah, potentially a hadith where the contradictions of the Quran, or if it agrees with the Quran and why we should completely disregard the hadith and all that kind of stuff, talking to you about sciences of the hadith and all those things. I take a subject under 9 minutes. This way, you will not have any excuse as to why you didn't listen to my talk. It's incredible that I cover in three parts a topic about those kids that are born out of an illegitimate marriage and why these people are not considered bastards, so to speak. And then somebody comes to me and asks me a question about those very kids. How does that make you feel? Well, that's exactly it. So those under 9 minutes should be more than enough to feed your ignorance and to eliminate, add more information, more knowledge to you, add more value to your life. And that's so that you can actually start living, appreciating what Allah has done, is doing, will do for us. We are paying an extremely huge, heavy price. It's hefty, big, it's incredible price for ignoring the Qur'an altogether and living only in what Ibn Baz said, Ibn Uthaymeen said, this Sheikh said, Ibn Taymiyyah said, and your brain is continuously, it's never-ending manipulation of your brain away from the Qur'an. If it was to bring you closer to the Qur'an, I wouldn't mind. But actually, it's not. The more you listen to our sheikhs, the more you listen to the hadith, the more you're taken away from the Qur'an. As I said before, on Judgment Day, there is only one and only book that will be on Judgment Day, the Qur'an and the Qur'an alone. Just on Judgment Day, there'll be the Gospel and the Gospel alone. It'll be the Torah and the Torah alone. They won't be Moses said, Jesus said, Muhammad said, no, none of that. On Judgment Day, when the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad, will hold the Qur'an and point to us, and so will Musa when he holds the Torah and points to his people, and so will Jesus when he holds the Gospel or the Injil and points to his people, and so will Ibrahim and any messenger that received a book to his people will carry that book. But our Prophet, our Messenger, the one sent to us, will say one word, Ya Allah, Inna qawmi takhadu hadha al-Qur'ana mahjura. My people, my followers, the Muslims, have taken it upon themselves to ignore, abandon the Qur'an. And guess what? If you don't rush now to the Qur'an, you'll be amongst those people that the Messenger will witness against you. Under 9 minutes is here for you. Use it. And please, it's just 9 minutes. You can listen to it as you walk to the station, on tube, or anywhere. Enough said, to the next topic, inshallah, when I start telling you about people, companions, that used to flirt with the wives of the messenger, they used to woo the wives of the messenger, and how the wives of the messenger also used to love it when they were flirted with. Incredible, isn't it? It's all in the Quran. Until my first installment, stay in the mercy of Allah, and I see you, and I welcome you in the Under 9 Minutes series. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, your brother Abdusalam.